I'm about to join a group of Chinese scientists on a remarkable journey.
Hello.
Hello, you ready?
Ready.
I'm ready.
We're flying to the island of Moheli, the smallest and most isolated part of the Comoros archipelago, where I'll have the chance to witness a controversial medical experiment in action. But that could be about to change. The Chinese are attempting to eliminate malaria from Moheli with a highly unconventional approach, experimenting on an island population of human guinea pigs. They've already produced some astonishing results against the deadly disease.
Chinese scientists, Chinese medical workers, in the search for eradicating malaria, have been working for 1,000 years.从植物药到化学药，到现在我们找到一个好的方法。
While most of the world's experts insist a global cure is at least 40 years away, the Chinese team led by Professor Song JiangPing are claiming that they can do it in a decade.
十年消灭疟疾，可以挽救一千万以上的人口的生命。
At Moheli's tiny airstrip, the Chinese researchers are warmly welcomed, and their strategy is being strictly enforced, much to the delight of Professor Song.
It's medicine of malaria.
Very good, very good. He says it's preventive malaria.
To eradication.
Everyone who enters this island by air or by sea must swallow a special tablet formulated by the Chinese team. There are no exceptions. It's a key part of the contentious technique they're using here, known as mandatory mass drug administration. And it's causing a serious division between East and West.
So, China, I'm not talking about Chinese scientists and Western scientists. Some ideas are different. Chinese people are about practical.讲究实际的效果，西方的专家更多谈究的是程序，所谓的 scientific evidence， 讲究程序，程序好不好？程序好，但是程序能不能发现，能不能有创新？程序走下来是很难有创新，你只有从实践才有创新。我们始终讲实在出真知。
It's a practice that appears to have paid off. Just months after starting the project in November 2007, Moheli's infection rate was slashed from 22% to less than 2%, all by a simple four-tablet treatment.
Our infection prevention team's main work is called Fast Track.
Here in their island laboratory, Professor Song JiangPing is now leading dozens of his researchers in a final scientific assault on the remaining pockets of infection, hoping to declare the island malaria-free before the year is out.
Our team's main work is to find out how to find the 140 pests that have been infected. So, as you can see here,这些工作人员的话呢，他们的主要工作就进行大量的筛选，筛选以后进行阳性的服药，阳性病人进阳性的这个岛民进行服药。
It's a big day in the village of Wanani. Vice President of the Comoros is coming to celebrate the Chinese achievements.This mountain village was one of the worst areas for malaria on Moheli because of the mosquito-infested jungle that surrounds it, but not any longer. On the edge of Wanani, the professor is keen to show me the village hospital, which now stands empty.
This hospital, in the 实施项目之前，也就是在2007年11月份之前， 这个医院是爆满的，很多疟疾病人，也有不少儿童得了疟疾死在这里。所以今天我们来到这里的话呢，就是没有疟疾病人。
Professor Song JiangPing says the dramatic success here is nothing short of a global breakthrough, and he's anxious to extend it to the world without delay.
Moheli 这个方案，这一年下来已经是没有问题，就非常明确的告诉大家，可以明非常明确的说，在世界范围内，可以在短时间内消灭，不用等，不用花费这么多生命。不用浪费这么多资源来等，我们积极主动地去工作，这一点是非常关键。
Ça a été un résultat rapide et nous tous, on était émus sur la rapidité de la réduction de la maladie.
Moheli's public health director, Fatanul Wafik, is astonished at the Chinese progress.He says malaria had long been established as the island's deadly scourge.
Dans l'histoire, on a connu, Moheli a connu toutes les formes du paludisme, et des familles ont resté pauvres depuis des années à cause des charges très élevées, le fait de prendre en charge les cas du paludisme.
The island's malaria death toll has been at zero for more than a year. And Wafik's convinced that Moheli will soon become famous for its part in an extraordinary medical advance.
Je pense qu'on mérite d'être observé. Je souhaiterais peut-être que Moheli serait une étoile au niveau du monde.Je ne rêve pas, mais c'est la même ambition quand on a déclaré le fait de se débarrasser du paludisme. Aujourd'hui, je peux aussi prôner le droit de rêver en disant que Moheli serait aussi une référence importante au niveau mondial.
The astonishing results achieved in the Comoros trace their origins here.To the University of Traditional Medicine in Guangzhou, and to this man, Professor Li Guoqiao, one of China's leading authorities on malaria.
This college.
His research began in an effort to help communist troops during the Vietnam War. The result was a drug based on a traditional herb identified 1600 years ago by a Chinese doctor.
这个作者的话呢，这个医生叫做葛洪，所以他在这个书啊讲得非常清楚。他是说，青蒿一窝，以水治，绞治浸服治，可以治疗疟疾。
By studying this plant, the Chinese were able to identify what the world now knows as artemisinin, the most effective cure for malaria.On Moheli, Professor Li's team are using a powerful combination of artemisinin with two other drugs. And while expanding their achievements from a tiny island to an entire continent like Africa might seem fanciful, Professor Song JiangPing is convinced that with enough money and coordination, it will work, despite the skeptics.
Okay, 现在我承认你在一个小岛里面可以把疟疾消灭，哪怕是个比较大的岛里面，也可以把那疟疾消灭。问题是，非洲是个大陆，非常非常大。我假如你站在卫星，这个卫星来看地球的话，你非洲也不是一个岛吗？消灭疟疾方案是一样的，理由是一样的，只要你这个能够同时来组织落实这个工作，就是很简单的，你也是一样的道理啊。
To that end, plans are well underway to extend the experiment to the rest of the Comoros, and then to its much larger neighbor, Madagascar. But the Chinese efforts to expand their bid to eliminate malaria has encountered a major hurdle, and one that threatens to kill off the global rollout of the new artemisinin-based medication. And it's not logistics or money that's standing in their way, but the world's largest public health authority, the WHO.
This strategy is not internationally recognized. And why WHO is not directly part of this.
While the Chinese believe they're on the edge of an international breakthrough, the World Health Organization is not convinced. Its representative in the Comoros, Dr. Kassan Kogno, says their testing hasn't been thorough enough.
It went through three steps. It didn't go through the four steps. And now as it is not, it didn't go through the fourth step, we are not, WHO didn't recognize these drugs.
Now, for some people looking at the situation, they would consider it quite strange that the WHO has no direct contact with the Chinese. Why is that?
Yes, because if the drug is not recognized and we go within the team and they didn't follow the WHO regulation on the drugs, and after some years there is a problem, they will say it is WHO job.
This particular approach being used in the Comoros has never been written up and published in a peer-reviewed journal. So it hasn't seen the light of day through that important mechanism.
Sir Richard Feacham is one of the world's leading figures in the struggle against malaria.
Experts in this room will differ, but my hunch is that we're talking about 2050, 2060, something like that. That's about the time that we can hope to see a malaria-free planet.
Last month, he kicked off the Asia-Pacific Malaria Initiative in Brisbane, addressing some of the region's top experts. But Professor Li and his team from Guangzhou weren't invited. While the Chinese claims might excite the public imagination, Western scientists remain unimpressed.
Interesting. Anecdotes are interesting. They incite the curiosity. You know, this sounds rather good. Tell me more. Is the reaction, I think, to these reports. But it falls short, it falls way short, of a peer-reviewed scientific journal publication, and that's really what we need now.
While the Chinese team haven't published any results yet, they're still collecting data and trying to stamp out the final traces of malaria on Moheli.
1 hour the person stay in their house here, one hour stay outside, okay. Like this.
So they get mosquitoes from inside and from
outside, yeah.
Okay. I've joined them at night as they travel around almost every village on the island collecting mosquitoes from volunteers who wait to get bitten.
If the mosquito is here, the person he know the mosquito is here and he take the is. And we use some cotton and to keep here.
They're looking for the type of mosquito called Anopheles, the only species to transmit malaria.
Anopheles. In total, I have take 12 mosquitoes and four of them Anopheles.
Village by village, night after night, the Chinese are hoping that their painstaking efforts will satisfy the meticulous standards of Western scientists.
These results will be very, very scientific, very, very exact compared to.
So this should be quite an acceptable result for the World Health Organization.
I hope so.
The catalyst for this East-West division came when the WHO learned of their plans to use artemisinin en masse in the Comoros.
This is because this is a very new technology. After it's released, many experts have a lot of doubts. They think this is impossible. Because how can it be eliminated? They think this is a fantasy, a dream.
One of the WHO's biggest concerns was that artemisinin's use in a mass campaign might lead to the emergence of a resistant strain of the disease. And that would mean the best anti-malarial known to man would be lost forever.
青蒿素是很好的药，我也同意了。但正是因为青蒿素是很好的药，非常优秀的药，所以你不能在非洲随便用哈，是欧洲用药。因为你把这个青蒿素最好的药都用出抗性来以后，我们怎么办呢？
Is there a concern that this drug that they're using, that there could be some resistance problem, or is that not an issue with this drug?
Myself, I am a little concerned because the strategy is at the starting point, they will give a full treatment. After it will be a prevention, which means that there is a minimal doses. And with all the drugs in the world, when you have a minimal dose, there is a risk. I am not sure, but there is a risk that there will be a resistance.
While it's quick to criticize, the WHO itself is far from blameless when it comes to malaria resistance. In 2004, almost a dozen of the world's leading malaria scientists wrote a stinging article. In it, they accused the WHO of approving cheap medicines that were increasingly ineffective, allowing drug-resistant malaria to thrive. With their competency under fire, there was a swift response.
It was a very helpful wake-up call. And
at the time, Sir Richard Feachum was head of the Global Fund, the world's single biggest financer for efforts to fight malaria. The fund was also accused of complicity in the monotherapy scandal, but Feachum says it was an important turning point towards combination therapy.
In a very short period of time, something like 80 countries changed policies, made new requests to the Global Fund, and the world changed very rapidly. I mean, I've never known it in my history of international public health, such a rapid, large-scale shift from one kind of treatment to another kind of treatment.
Despite the West's mistakes just a few years ago, Sir Richard cuts the Chinese little slack. He says until their results are published in scientific journals, their claims are worthless.
There are reasonable standards of evidence in the medical and public health world, and they're important standards because they protect the public from dangerous or hurtful things being done to them in the name of science or medicine.
Professor Song says it's a typical response from Western scientists.
尤其是在青蒿素研究里面，我们是在国际交流里面，我们是磕磕碰碰，也就是说，你说这个挫折也好，还是什么也好，反正我们一开始说的东西，人家都不相信，别人都不相信我们。
But back in the village of Wanani, no one is looking down on the Chinese efforts. Here, the scientists are guests of honour, and the Comorians are giving Islamic prayers of thanks for eradicating malaria from the village. Officials from the WHO are also here, handing out mosquito nets to every family in the village to ensure that malaria doesn't return. But there's one more gift in store for these poor villagers. The Chinese have paid for water to be piped up the mountain and into the village. It's a sign of their long-term commitment here.
We Chinese government is completely in the village for the people of Africa to do some practical things.
China's ambassador to the Comoros, Tao Wang, is among today's guests. He says China's growing role in Africa is viewed with suspicion in the West, and that's fueling the criticism of the malaria team's achievements.
不愿意看到中国的发展，不愿意看到，在中国在非洲等其他国家产生大的中国的影响，甚至害怕是由于中国的发展扩大影响而影响他们在非洲等国家的固有的秩序影响。
But the world's malaria experts insist that no one has closed the door on the Chinese efforts. In fact, in a sign that augurs well, Sir Richard Feacham has agreed to fund the translation of thousands of pages of Chinese research into English.
We have indeed had, up to now, an inadequate communication caused by language, very easy to understand, and we're certainly very committed to bridging that, because we are absolutely convinced that there is a wealth of evidence and knowledge in China that the rest of the world can benefit from.
While Feacham is taking tentative steps to bridging the gap, so too are the Chinese. They expect to publish their results in a Western journal soon, and they're hoping their approach will be vindicated, saving millions of lives and earning the people of Moheli a place in history.
We hope, we ask the world, the government, the organization, the people, to join in this great dream. 这是个非常神圣的事业，是造福我们子孙后代的事业。